me with Scrappy. He's a former sparring partner of Manny Pacquiao. He actually told me that sparring Manny almost made him quit boxing. Tell me about that.
No, this made me double think about things. When
Why? So what? You're in the ring. You don't know what to expect because Manny wasn't as famous as he is today.
No.
And you're a talented fighter. You're a tough dude. I've seen you fight.
Right.
So what happens? You get in the ring to spar him.
I just got in the ring, spar him. I walked out the corner. I told Boston, like, dude, this guy hits hard. And he goes, I'll go back out there. We sparred about 5 more rounds after that. And shit, I remember driving home thinking, man, what's wrong with me? And then we kept sparring. I kept going back and sparring a lot with him after that. And then he fought on the... I think it was Barrera and so on after that. And I realized, oh man, this guy's blowing up, you know? So it was great sparring though.
When he landed those bombs, what did it feel like? A 2x4, a crowbar, a baseball bat, anything human?
You know what? He was probably hit me the hardest in my career, you know? I've sparred with Robert Guerrero, I've sparred with a lot of other world champions and stuff like that. And I'll say he's the hardest hitting one out of all.
Let me ask all 3 or 4 of you guys, May 2nd, break it down. As a person who knows Manny, who spent time with him in the ring?
I'm not going to give it to Mayweather, though. I mean, Manny's my boy and stuff, but, you know, right there, Kid Hollywood, still with the money. But, yeah, Mayweather. I'm going to box him, be smart, picking his punches and stuff like that. I know a lot of people think because of the aggression, the way Pacquiao's going to be, but I think, you know, he'll do it. I mean, Mayweather looking good right now.
Is that your son?
Yes, my boy.
Congratulations. Yeah. You won tonight. Your dad's a fighter. Your grandfather's a fighter trainer. Tell me about fighting tonight and winning and May 2nd. What do you think?
It felt good to finally fight again. I went out there, executed my game plan, boxed, and that was it. And then I think Mayweather's going to take it because I'm just a boxing fan. I just like boxers in general.
Coach?
I'm the other way. I want Manny Pacquiao. I think Pacquiao, like I said, I love that guy. I think strategy, I just hope he doesn't, you know, get too careless and run into it. But like Mayweather, when he fought Madonna, though, he got hit and he got rocked pretty good, too, and stuff, you know. And Manny hits a lot harder than Madonna does, too. So I think I take Pacquiao.
You know? When you guys watch the fight together, do you guys get animated? Is your dad yelling and you're yelling?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Well, what happened?
We have two different styles. My fighting style, his fighting style, but that from back in the day. So, you know, we start talking, we, you know, get into a little
thing. Any bet going on with May 2nd? Any challenges?
We should make a bet. Out right here live. $500 bet, dude.
$500 bet.
$500 bet. You see him shaking out here. Mayweather.
What do you tell Floyd and what do you tell Manny if they're watching?
Floyd, you know, he knows what to do. I mean, what can you tell Floyd Mayweather? You know, he's just going to adapt. I think he's going to do his best. He looks strong. He looks solid. I mean, it's going to be a great fight. Good luck.
Defense first.
And I will Pacquiao, you know, just don't be careless, buddy. Keep your hands up at all times and break that shoulder down of his, man. That's all you got to do, break his shoulder.
When I was a kid, Mayweather was, I was in a tournament in San Diego, and he was there, actually, and kept telling me defense is the key, and I was always aggressive.
How old were you? How old was he?
I think I was, I was 15 years old, and he was right there working in the corner, not corner, but he was ringside. He kept telling defense is the key. At the time, I didn't realize what that meant. As I adapted more and fought more, I realized how much defense and working and watching him has made my fights easier and a lot better, counter punching and stuff.
Before I end this interview, tell us about your amateur pro card, the location, the time, and all the good stuff.
I'm the new matchmaker for PR Sports.
Okay.
It's actually new companies here, and we're going to rock and roll in the Simi Valley area May 30th. Scrappy will be on the card.
You're fighting?
Yes, sir.
Oh, what's your record now?
Yeah. Nine wins, one loss, one draw.
That's pretty decent.
But we actually have, USA Boxing is where we put in amateurs and pros together. Father and son the first night. I actually have a gal and her son's going to fight too as well. So it's going to be a back night. Simi Town Center, Simi Valley, PR Sports. It's going to be a great
show. The date, one more time?
May 30th. You can get tickets at my cell, 805-206-9403. And or call Kickers Boxing.
One more time, you're selling slowly?
805-206-9403. It's my cell number. Call.
People will be calling and texting you, so.
You know,
there you have it, Scrappy. PleaseReport.com. Melissa Quack reporting.